The Forum for Democratic Change Katonga faction, led by the Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, who is currently the interim party president, has continued to fight for recognition amid the escalating misunderstandings among the party members.
I am very happy that NEC has resumed. We are going to resurrect and resuscitate all the FDC organs. This particular meeting now looks like an inauguration.
They have today held their first National Executive Committee meeting, which was held at Dr. Besigye's offices along Katonga Road in Kampala. The closed-door meeting was attended by over 20 National Executive Committee members. After the meeting, the Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, the FDC party interim president, addressed the media and explained the meeting resolutions.
And see how we can work within the framework given to us, the time frame of 6 months. And bottom line is about restitution of sanity within the party, restitution of constitutional governance, bringing the party back onto the rail, and also respect for the sanctity of the party constitution, because our colleagues are hell-bent on violating and abrogating the party constitution. So we want to restore constitutional order in the party, because now you'll agree the party is being put in shambles by our colleagues who had messed up each and everything.
The most dishonest person is Amria. He knows that meetings have been held for the last 3 years. He projects a different Amria to the public, and there is a different Amria working internally. If they come here and apologize and return Museveni's money, we can allow them to be ordinary members, but there is no way you're going to be read by someone who is compromised, and they know it.
Among the resolutions was to write to the country's electoral commission body, informing them about the changes in the leadership of the FDC party, with Erias Lukwago now the interim party president, while the incumbent party president Patrika Muriato-Boy and the party general secretary Nandala Mafabi are on suspension. They insist that Amuriat and Nandala have to face the party's disciplinary committee.
We've already written to the Electoral Commission to register the resolution. We have written to banks warning them against working with Nanda or Ekanya, because both of them are removed. Once we are done with the administrative issues, then the next campaign is to go out, to recruit, to carry out free and fair elections.
We hope all those that have been summoned will appear before the disciplinary committee, because they clearly went against the FDC constitution. In short, I would say that they committed treason. Should they fail to appear before the disciplinary committee, for me, as an FDC member, I'm not worried. Because beyond the disciplinary committee, in FDC and FDC supporters have different ways of punishing.
During this meeting, a draft roadmap for the party's parallel internal elections was released by the interim electoral commission boss, Michael Kabanzi-Guruka. It is this roadmap which will lead them to the massive mobilization campaigns which they plan to embark on soon.
But as the FDC, headed by our president, the Honorable Erias Lukwago, we are in high gear. We are now mobilizing. We are going to have a very big event for the youths here on 4th, and the women are going to be here. And you know, the whole country is excited. The whole country is in celebratory mood. So for me, I can say this has just started.
Well, the roadmap will be out on Monday. The roadmap will be out on Monday on what we shall be doing, when and where. But for now, get it from me that we have resolved and we are not turning back. We are moving forward until this country is fully liberated. Fully liberated.
Meanwhile, the FDC faction of Naja Nankumbi is busy organizing for its delegates conference, which is due on 6th of October this year. The party members who were nominated were given leeway by the party's electoral commission chairperson, Boniface Totorubuka Bamwenda, to start campaigns, which are to conclude on October 4th. Report compiled by Jali Adnamwaya for the news.